entrepreneurship, it's very key to national development. And it's a component of education. We see it as that aspect that provides individuals with skills, attitude, and knowledge, such that they become innovative and will be able to create things that will improve on the lives of others. And as a follow-up to that, and for the need to develop young entrepreneurs within the teaching and other youth within the society, we decided to empower teachers who in turn are expected to influence a change in behavior and regulate the mindset of our own students. And we have sent a total number of 11 staff to the University of Wolverhampton. The whole idea is for them to get trained so that in turn they can replicate that training in their various schools, and so that they can positively impact on the lives of the students. So far so good. They have returned. They've been able to replicate such studies. They've been able to influence a large number of young men and women, and who have now imbibed the culture of becoming entrepreneurs themselves. As I speak to you, we are having a partnership with Niger's government on how we can impact and develop entrepreneurs from among the youth population in Niger State. Just recently, the Central Bank of Nigeria has also sent us a proposal, given the fact that we are gradually picking up, providing a lot of information and support to entrepreneurial groups in the school and Niger State at large. Niger State College of Education, Minna, is in partnership with Center for African Entrepreneurship and Leadership, University of Wolverhampton, and Dr. Pascal, having been the director of that center, has also been appointed by Niger State College of Education, Minna, as a consultant to superintend over the project. So far, the project is ongoing, and we are, by the special grace of God, meeting up with the timelines as specified in the agreement jointly signed between the college and the Center for African Entrepreneurship and Leadership of University of Wolverhampton.
I was the leader of the delegation that went to University of Wolverhampton for training on entrepreneurship. Since our return, we have tried to put into practice some of the things that we learned. In fact, our visit was an eye-opener, because some of these things that we do in the college, especially in the training of students, we have been doing it just as an academic practice, you know, just the classroom, then probably taking them out to the school farms for practice. We have never thought of going into a large quantity or even commercial quantity production. But since our visit to the University of Wolverhampton, we discovered that we could encourage students to go into commercial ventures, not just for academic purposes, but even for raising funds, both for themselves and for the institution, and for enriching the society at large. So when we came back, the college retained us as a team to work within the college, and the report we presented to the governing council attracted the attention of the state government. For example, in the Agri department, we have gone beyond just making poultry and then selling the live birds or dress birds to making larger production where we can dress the birds and then sell them outside, you know, going into fish pond, fish production, where instead of selling the fish after maturing, we're going to dressing them, maybe smoking them, dressing them, and then producing a large quantity and selling them. Now, these are issues that we never thought of before. We could even attract people from outside the college to come into the college to invest into particular areas of need within the society. Also in the home economics department, you know, instead of making students just learn fashion and design within the college, we have gone beyond that, you know, training them to go into commercial production, because instead of just working with them, you can collect material from outsiders and then work with them. And these are areas that we have gone into that is as a result of our training at the University of Wolverhampton. The training was actually very, very useful to us, and we hear from other colleagues of mine that went with us to see some of the things they are doing. And it has made even some lecturers to go into private practice, kind of, that is, making the little production at home. For me, I have started a fish pond, you know, in my house, you know, since I have facilities, so that I don't just depend on salary.
I encourage students to form entrepreneurship club, and we started putting animals in the farm, such animals like cattle, goats, and sheep, turkey. We didn't go in for green vegetables, which we did there during the dry season. And this is imparting on our students, because we train them how to produce this agricultural products, such as these animals and even some vegetables. So most of our students now have done a lot of work on poultry. Many of them can go to their villages and establish such poultry. And some of our staff too, we encourage them to even bring their animals to keep in the farm, so that we help them the addition, value addition. We used to sell our animals, just live animals, but now we are making efforts and we are doing it already. Like poultry, we dress them and we sell them in stores. That fetches us more money, and we also get more market. And even though we are planning in future, we also begin to do our beef, and we'll be selling. In fact, we are already establishing a farm shop, which we saw over there.
We are taught how to take entrepreneurship proper. We have lecture, we went on teaching, we are able to see a lot of experience on how to teach entrepreneurship particularly. So when I came back from this trip, I have been trying my best to transfer the knowledge I acquired from abroad to my students. Presently on ground now, we can see a lot of products. These students are doing this practically on their own. They are doing, learning entrepreneurship based on experience, not theory. Because entrepreneurship is all about experience. Allow the student to do it. Let them do it on their own. By the time they do it, they will be able to know the actual experience on how to run an enterprise. Most of them engage on different products. You can see yogurt, milk, meeting, and other things. From this experience, I'm sure that in the near future, these students will leave this place and then start their own. And we all know the situation of our economy, that now governments can no longer employ everybody. They are trying to put programs on ground whereby people should be able to acquire skills that will enable them to stand on their own. And that is what we are trying to do in major stakeholders of education, particularly the home economic department. We have a lot of deep concerning entrepreneurship. We are training students on how to manage the guest house using our flat. We are training students on cosmetology, producing cosmetic liquids for better and so on. By the end of the program, I'm sure that by special grace of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be able to put this into practice. I have one day, two day discussion with them. Then I leave them. Let me see what they can come up. We started this thing last week. Amazing. See it on the table. They did it on their own. The label, the packaging, they use your creativity. And that is how they are doing it outside there. They need students to think, and bring out something they can do on their own. So from there they're going to develop this entrepreneurship skill.
School of Art, that is textile ceramics. We insert on board practical production of those things and the processes and the end product to create a sort of market.
After our training, we are more equipped. We came back, we are told on how to, you know, how to use our machines to operate. So there are some machines, we have them here. We don't even know how to operate them. It was when we got there, they taught us how to operate those machines. And those machines are just geared towards how to produce products, right? That is why you bring your skills to play. So like in auto department, we were taught how to use this OBD, what you call scanner. We have them here, but we don't even know how to use it. Not until we had that training from Wolverhampton. If you go to building two, they told us local ways of producing bricks. We have some of those machines here, but we are now more strengthened, more equipped to use those machines. So we use those skills we have there and to teach our students. Our students are doing very well, because if we rate them now before they were Wolverhampton, we discover that they are more productive in terms of skills. The Niger State government also picks interest. We start to keep into this entrepreneurship training. So presently we have a proposal which is already at advanced stage, where two trainees are nominated from various local governments. They are coming down here.
From what my colleagues have said, from what we have all said, I want to really thank God for this partnership. The training that we went for at the Center for African Entrepreneurship and Leadership Center at the University of Wolverhampton, it was an intensive program for entrepreneurship and capacity building, where each participant was given a certificate. So with this certification, it has grounded us, you know, as we came back to the state and presented it to the council members, and we have continued to work with the Center for African Entrepreneurship and Leadership training in the area of curriculum building. We want to make a curriculum, designing a curriculum in entrepreneurship and setting up entrepreneurship centers that will prepare our students, you know, as they graduate, they can become entrepreneurs on their own. And in these centers we are building, is not just for the benefit of our students, but for the benefit of the youths within the society, where youths can come in and they also receive training on entrepreneurship, and they will also be able to go and become full-fledged entrepreneurs on their own. I think the support we are receiving from the state government, the support that we are also receiving from the Center for African Entrepreneurship and Leadership at the University of Wolverhampton, is making things easier for us. Because some of the things that we didn't know about, or some of the areas that we are having challenges, we can easily call. Especially Dr. Pascal has been very helpful to us with Professor Trasla. We have been working with them, and it has really been a very good working relationship.